sorry, the momentum got away from you a little bit in the second quarter. How much of that was your lack of familiarity with what they might run with the new coaching staff and or end up running 43 plays in the first half, which looked like it fatigued your defense?
I don't know. I mean, I had the feel and the flow of the game pretty – we felt like we could score, and we were going to score enough points. I didn't feel like I had to click over and tell Bob to bring pressure and get the ball back. I didn't feel like at any time that we were in that position that take the ball – you know, let's get the ball back no matter what. Either they score, right – or we get them off the field. I didn't feel that at any time because I felt like we were going to put enough points on the board. So I was okay with the dink and dunk that they were going to exhibit on offense. If they were going to continue to just take stick routes and swings, I was okay in letting that happen. And that's how we played defensively. And we knew kind of that was the plan for them. And I never felt that. There was only one time in the third quarter where they had an extended drive that I said, let's get some pressure. We got some pressure. Then we got the next score, and then if they wanted to continue that. So I really never felt that at any time.
In your assessment, without looking at film, of the inside linebacker play?
First half spotty, second half firm. Much better. I thought that second half we fitted the plays a lot better. You know, one of the hallmarks of our defense, no easy runs on the perimeter. We had one easy run on the perimeter. That's very unusual to happen. In the first half, we had one. They had none in the second half. So, and again, you know, they're playing volume-wise. Fox and Calabrese, their volume was way up. But I thought in the second half, they played much, much better.